Main processing is carried out by two identical flight management guidance computers, FMGC, which normally work in tandem. Together they are known as the Flight Management Guidance System, FMGS. The pilots provide inputs to the FMGS using two multipurpose control and display units, MCDUs, on the center pedestal and a flight control unit, FCU, located on the glare shield. The flight management part of the FMGS controls navigation, flight planning, performance optimization, predictions and display management. The flight guidance part provides flight director, autopilot and autothrust commands. The flight augmentation part provides flight envelope computation, maneuvering speed computation, wind shear detection, alpha floor protection and various YAW functions. The FMGCs normally receive information from on-side sensors and communicate between themselves to validate data. The FCU feeds both FMGCs. The master FMGC is determined by autopilot and/or flight director engagement. FMGC 1 will act as master if autopilot 1 is selected on or both autopilots are on or both flight directors are on. The autothrust is driven by the master FMGC. The flight directors are always driven from their on-side FMGC. If the crosstalk between the two FMGCs is lost, the FMGCs can operate independently. This mode of operation is indicated by an amber IND light at the top of each MCDU. In independent mode, the same information must be entered into both MCDUs to receive the same guidance. In the event of loss of an FMGC, the remaining FMGC continues to operate normally. If the lost FMGC was master, the autopilot and autothrust will disengage. The autopilot of the healthy FMGC can be engaged, and subsequently the autothrottle can be engaged. This situation, known as single mode, is indicated by an amber FM1 light at the top of the MCDU on the failed side. The MCDU will now be copy of the MCDU driven by the healthy FMGC. The FMA will enunciate for an example 2FD2 to indicate that both flight directors are being driven from one FMGC. The healthy FMGC also tunes the offside NAV aids. To restore the ND on the failed side, the range and mode must be set identically to that set on the healthy side. If an FMGC has a software problem, the FMGS will temporarily revert to single mode while the affected FMGC auto-resets. This may result in autopilot and autothrottle disconnect and reversion to selected modes. Map not avail is shown on the ND of the affected side and the status page with a "Please wait" message appears on both MCDUs. Use of the MCDUs should be avoided during the reset as it will increase the reset time. Reset usually takes a few seconds. The FCU display is driven by two redundant FCU controllers. A single failure will have very little effect. A double FCU failure will lead to the loss of both autopilots, both flight directors and the autothrust. The autothrust will revert to thrust locked until the thrust levers are manually moved. All targets are lost on the PFD. The EFIS control panels are lost, leading to a reversion to STD, ROS NAV 80 nautical miles on the NDs and a reversion needle selection of VAR1 and ADF2. Weather radar image is also lost. A locked MCDU may be recovered by turning it off, then back on after 5 seconds. This failure is not automatically detected. An amber fail on the MCDU requires the same procedure.